April 26, Philippe Labro, French novelist, journalist and director, gave a talk at the ambassador's residence as part of the Kalorama lectures. He talked about the cultural influences and interaction between the United States and France. Mr. Labro underlined the major influence that the United States has on French and international media. The French press is fond of using little expressions from the American language.
I got a good example for you. The other day, on the front page of Le Figaro Madame, which is a very respectful, bourgeois, weekly magazine, the supplement of Daily Figaro, there was this beautiful French title. Boostez votre glamour. I blinked and read once again. It was boostez votre glamour. They didn't say, faites progresser votre charme. You have magazines now that just arrived in the past few months now. One of them is titled B, B-E. It's not called Être, it's called B. There's another one called Envy, E-N-V-Y, and not Envy, E-N-V-I-E. And another one, Closer, and not Plus Près. Okay? And to finish these items, the title of one of the most popular one-woman show in Paris right now. By the way, it's a one-woman show. It's not Un spectacle d'une femme. By Florence Foresti is, I'm sorry, ladies, the title is Motherfucker.
Philippe Labro also explained that there had been many fruitful exchanges in the cinematic field.
Hollywood is probably, certainly, today as well as yesterday, the most efficient exporter of American culture and manners and way of life and mores and gestures and talks, behavior. And the French cinema has been very influenced by American cinema. In Abou Tsouf, there is a moment where Jean-Paul is facing a mirror and he does like that. It's a Humphrey Bogart gesture.
Then again, it was the French New Wave of the 1960s and the elevation of the film director to the rank of auteur that allowed certain American directors to see themselves as real artists and not just as movie makers.
And the new American generation, Scorsese, Coppola, Arthur Penn, Bob Rafelson, Spielberg in his beginnings anyway, all claimed their debts to Godard and Truffaut. Their films were impregnated by the freedom of La Nouvelle Vague.
Philippe Labro believes that you can see the same pattern in literature. While Hemingway, Steinbeck and Faulkner are revered in France, they were, to a large extent, influenced by 19th century France, Flaubert, Balzac and Zola. Philippe Labro believes that French admiration for these American authors is based on their atypical personalities. Most American authors were adventurers.
Jack Kerouac was on the road, while others were in Le Flore, sipping coffee, or Chélip, or Eau de Mago.
Philippe Labro was asked about the links between American and French music trends. He responded that French music has for a long time been influenced by American styles, and that is still the case today.
It's true that today some French singers, a new generation of French singers, write their songs in English. Now, it's not snobbery or whatever. They say that the English words, the English language, fits more the rhythm of modern music, which is true, in a way. After all, rock and roll is not called rocher et roule. So, Flaubert used to say, la bêtise consiste à conclure. I'm not going to conclude. I'm just going to think that we must more and more boost notre glamour.